Hello everybody, welcome to my hell right now. So I'm trying to get RetroArch to RetroArch like it's supposed to. I want to play some Dreamcast on here. So, what do I do? Okay, it keeps saying the controller's connected. That's helpful. Okay, because it keeps popping up and it keeps connecting the controller, my little remote guy here that you can't see because it's dark in here, will sometimes double up inputs. That's fun. I don't even care. Let's see here. Will this run? Failed to load content. Okay, let's hit back. Let's see. Did my settings not save this time? Okay, yeah. It's using Vulkan, so let's change that back. Let's quit so it saves. Let's first stop it. Make sure it's actually not in the background. Let's go back to it. Let's make sure that's saved this time. There we go, we're using GL. Okay. Let's just do Dynamite Cop. It should be easy, I guess. Let's see if this works. So, I'm holding the controller in my hand. I just pressed a button, and that's why it says it's configured for port 0. Yeah, I know. Okay, now we're back here. Cool. Okay, now I'm going back to the remote. So why'd you do that? Is everything here set right? Looks fine to me. Yeah, everything looks fine here. Okay, that's good. I guess all this is good. I'm not using threaded video. Because threaded video just crashes immediately. I'm not really sure why. Okay, let's try something that's not Dreamcast real quick. I don't even care which one I use. Let's just use this. Okay, that seems to want to work. Okay. Cool, I could skip through things here. So that seems to work. Looks good. Kind of. There's a couple glitches, but whatever. I didn't really set it up. That wall's missing, whatever. Okay, so that works. I mean, I didn't tweak the core or anything. Cool. Close content. Crazy Taxi. Before it goes anywhere, I am now hitting back. Cool. That's where I want to be. Options. Let's check everything here. Internal resolution 1440 by 1080. That's what I set it to. It is a Dreamcast. I don't know. Alpha sorting per triangle. I think it was on that before I changed it. What else do we have here? Yeah, I think I had all of this to say. Well, okay, so once I pick it, it puts me all the way back at the top. That's really annoying. So, there, I'll just press over instead. Turn threaded rendering off. Okay, so what do you think I do if I want to go back a menu? Obviously, if I hit right or left, it wants to change an option, so I'm going to hit back. Puts me back in the game. Hit back again, puts me here. So I'm gonna hit close content, hit back. I'm gonna quit so it saves it. I'm gonna do what I just did before, long press info, force stop, okay. or see if it runs. Got the controller in my hand. Oh, okay. Don't even need to do anything. I don't even know what that was. That was weird. Okay. I don't know what made that happen or what kind of screen that was. Let's try something else. Dead or Alive 2. Cool. Neat. Awesome. Cool. So what's making this do this? Nothing set here that's out of the norm. Let's go back to that so it loads up the core with settings I can configure. Let's hit back. Let's try one more thing. 640 by 480 on that. Double check these all again. I think that was on disable before. And I have to remember where the hell I was. That's really annoying. Whoever does that. Oh, okay, now we have to hit back. This is usability at its finest. I'm not even going to do the close thing. Okay, now it's going to be little. Don't you bet it's just going to crash. Yep, there you go. Cool, neat. Not Daytona, USA. That should be easy, right? These were working a second ago, kind of. Yeah, that one gets this far. Man, I had that one at the intro, too. This is great. I love this. This is all the things I really love doing. So that one got the furthest. Let's do that. What could I have set up wrong? I don't know at this point. I know I changed that from full speed to normal. I don't know why that would make it just not want to work. What else? Really ain't got nothing else. Oh, this is just a hellscape we live in here. Oh, come on. Okay, turn on. It was working before, wasn't it? I mean, we were just in it. So, start. Start. Yeah. You know, you were working. No, you're not. I don't know why. I don't know what you're doing with your life. What are you doing? I'm at a loss. I have no idea. It's not like Raycast is any better. Started up once, nothing shows up. It could be because I'm using a hard drive. I have no idea. So, let's go back. Oh, look, stuff. Kind of. Okay, let's go back. Nope, it's not gonna load anymore, is it? Oh, and it lost the second. Oh, now it's kind of getting these. This is just horrible. This is bad. Bad business right here. Oh, what about dolphin? Looks promising so far, doesn't it? So why is RetroArch such shit? This works. It works. Just straight up. No issue. Works. What else we got here? We got this. It's all my N64 games. And a pretty looking library. I could select them. Start them. Wow, look at that. I don't know why fucking RetroArch has to be the worst thing in existence. It's like no one actually tests it. It's crazy. I mean, it could be up to the different core designers. I don't know what you call them, programmers, implementers, but like the UI means a lot, and that's fucking broken compared to all of this other stuff that's like not an XMB interface. I don't know. I just want to record this because I was going through it and I needed other people to go through it with me. Thanks.